NBC Sports and the United States Golf Association proudly present the 123rd United States Women's Amateur Championship with uninterrupted coverage presented by Rolex. Early August in Los Angeles, relatively quiet period before the Rams get going, NFL, and their fans might not make as much noise as Taylor Swift did this past week at SoFi Stadium. The streaking Dodgers look primed for a deep playoff push at Chavez Ravine, but that's a month and a half away. Searching for sports drama in LA? It's behind the gates of Bel-Air Country Club, exuding Hollywood cool, but bringing match play heat this weekend. The golf course, one of the most ingeniously routed in the world. George C. Thomas using tunnels and elevators and bridges to get around, over and through the canyons in the neighborhood just north of Sunset Boulevard. And a look at the leaderboard. Catherine Rao, second trip to the quarterfinal, second consecutive trip. The sophomore at Princeton is in trouble against Rachel Heck, who won the NCAA individual title in 2021. Latanna Stone came from five down to beat Yana Wilson yesterday in the round of 16. Thienna Huynh is the only USGA champion of the eight remaining. She won the four ball last year. Anna Davis, one of three Californians, still standing at this point.
Used to. But Rachel Heck's not going to make many mistakes, so Catherine needs to make a charge.
Yeah, four up, Rachel Heck.
Rao still away at the seventh, her fourth shot, Amelia.
Yeah, just not able to, and she might end up conceding the hole at this point.
Yeah.
Maybe if it was 230, 240, certainly a layup. Off a downhill lie, back into the breeze. This is headed down the right side. She hit it way right yesterday, kind of on the line of Catherine's ball. Ended up on the ninth tee box, pitched it over the green, chipped in for birdie, and ended up winning the hole.
But you know, it's more these.
We got a good look at exactly what she needs to do. I imagine she'll be very conscious of her speed.
It's going to be good enough. She has not trailed them.
It's going to break pretty good to her right and be very fast. See how she just barely touched that. We need a little bit of legs. Coming back up the hill, breaking to her left. You know, Julie, sometimes these rounds, it's just looking probably the right side of that mound. Well, right side of the mound, spinning left, just an excellent golf shot. Painter and pianist.
And
but the golf,
do
not
it.
Her day.
Thank you.
On to the semifinals. 2021 NCAA individual champion.
Yeah, whatever. Meet in the middle somewhere.
Thank you.
I think in some ways Burko freed up. Two putts now for Latanna Stone to win the hole.
Yeah, we just saw Thienna Huynh hit it way over the green, and where that hole location, it was just going to be a tough up and down. So it's very well played by Latanna Stone, just to get it on the green, put the pressure on her partner.
Take a few steps back after the disappointment, the burn of what could have been, to say, you know what? I can get there again. I can keep battling. Probably going to be in another battle here, Rich, today. We've seen it from Stone all week long.
Just a little too much speed on that putt, and that's, you know, they're a little quicker today and haven't really had a lot of birdie opportunities in their match. Thienna made great eagle on number one.
I can't see it.
Beautiful shot. Can't see it, but you're going to absolutely love it.
Oh, I see
that
it.
Ball almost disappeared because it was tracking for the hole. A sensational shot by Latanna Stone. Thienna Huynh, this birdie putt at the eighth. That one got away from her.
Rich, I was listening to her little interview.
And 10 yards typically because it's slightly uphill.
That looks like it's drifting a little bit right.
Yeah, but that should be fine.
Oh, that's
again, everything funnels
shot.
In nicely.
Yes, I mean that if you could put it somewhere to putt it, that's a straight uphill putt, may move a little bit left to right. We saw her hit it over the green. We saw Catherine Raw just missed the same place. Everybody thinks it's going to come down a little bit right to left, but it doesn't.
Win four, Stone is two up.
Back one at the 11th, Stone, her second, two up in this match. Wonderfully done. And
training ROTC in Alabama.
Yeah, wonderful.
Thrilled to be playing golf.
Yeah, wonderful perspective. Oh, short miss there by Stone. That was to go three up. She's won 11 of her last 22 holes since being five down yesterday.
Thienna Huynh at the 12th. Par putt to tie the hole. Stay two down to Latanna Stone. No. Now in some trouble.
Four, Huynh, five, Stone is three up.
To Huynh for birdie, try to cut into that lead of Stones.
Mm.
Run out of holes if you're Thienna Huynh.
Yeah, she's missed a lot.
When we think about where she ended up, it was a great third shot, but really the layup shot that created this difficult fourth shot, but pulled that off. Incredible. Big putt here.
Excellent up and down by Latanna Stone.
Yeah, she worked hard for that bogey, I mean, for that par right there. That's a great par. Keeps the pressure right on.
It's not going to break a whole lot. I see this inside the hole.
Finally gets one of those par putts to drop.
This is Latanna Stone trying to close out her match.
And this is actually a hole location where players can get close to. Now it's downwind, so really just got to land it over the bunker and it will skip up to the back of the green.
Flag hunting.
It's playing 153 yards. They probably playing up six or about 160.
That'll do it. So Latanna Stone is on to the semifinals for what promises to be quite a matchup against Rachel Hack. It will be the third Curtis Cup teammate she will have faced. Already dispatched Amari Avery.
Congratulations.
And Rachel Keene. And tomorrow it is the red hot. Rachel Hack.
You saw how they both miss it to the right, and they both have long par putts, and that was a great putt right there. She got maybe got a little bit of a ream off of Kyra.
Lee, four. Borja, five. The match is tied.
And Heck will have a chance to close it out on the 11th. Now Borja has to go one up and slides by. Kyra Lee is over the green.
least two, if not, you know, Kyra's only won one hole and Thienna's won two holes. They have not really battled. This has been kind of tying each other. No one's really making a move on this match. I think after getting to meet all these eight wonderful ladies, they're all role models. I mean, they all been super outgoing.
Remember here, Marty Fish, tennis player. No, left all the way.
Lee, four, Borja, three. Borja is one up.
That's the one thing you just, you don't want to give gifts.
Head back to 11. Ooh. Got close to that penalty area for Kyra Lee. Borja's got a par putt remaining as well, so a little bit of a scratchy hole.
Captain, I agree. Soft-spoken, amazing man.
11, Hailey Borja for par to go two up.
Boy, that was a beautiful tempo stroke there.
Don't see her miss a lot of fairways, so bit of a surprise.
Yes, and it's going to go right to left on her bad with the green. The whole location over the left, she should be able to use that hill to her advantage. And we've seen that a lot, Burko, when you're coming out of that rough. It's just so hard to get it to stop.
This is Borja. She's two up.
Yeah, it looks like she got Kyra to mark her ball so she could go ahead and putt that. And that is beautifully done. Nice touch.
Not quite a must make, but important. She was up to it. Great tied hole.
Yeah, a couple of par putts here at 13, Rich. Hailey Borja, first up. Whew. How good is that?
Great putt on number 11 and an extremely great putt on there on 13. So
one of those must-haves for Kyra Lee. And she responds.
Just the third from Borja.
Little bit of a mistake there.
This is Hailey Borja. This is for birdie, already two up.
Yeah, we'll see how speedy this is.
Not
judge
the most
speed.
Dynamic of all the players in terms of power, but you know she has moxie and touch. Kyra Lee, this to tie the hole and avoid going three down. No. So.
Lee five, Borja four. Borja is three up.
With four to play.
Moment ago, Kyra Lee needs this for par. And a little hope as well from her opponent. Oh, that's clutch. Clutch.
Clutch putt.
Borja now to stay three up, Amelia.
Breaking just slightly to her right.
Not much changes from the swing to the putting stroke.
Sprinkler heads in her way at all, Amelia? Or is she going to try to go out? Up and over those?
Well, I think she needs to go over them, but it is a little bit of a dicey, narrow landing area.
All right, back at 16 now. Borja has this putt for par to win the match and advance to the semifinals. Amelia's there.
And the furthest she would have ever advanced in the four times she's competed here at the U.S. Women's Amateur. 2 years ago, she made it to the round of 16. And these are those pressure putts that you practice all the time on the practice putting green. It's going to break to her right. I see this about a ball out.
great up and down and superb Borja, performance.
Hailey Borja wins the match 3-2.
So Hailey Borja, 21 years old, University of Michigan, and Lake Forest, California is on to the semifinals. So one. Anna Davis.
Yeah, that's just a short iron again, drawing it in to this back right hole location. Now facing a delicate sliding putt. No problem. Oh, there's a concession. So sometimes a player will keep that mark down and they'll intend to give the putt, but just don't want their opponent to have the luxury of having that mark in the pocket.
She's done just about that. Talented young player, Kay.
You know what? That was a smart move to go down that fairway with the right-hand hole location. Great, gave her a great angle. Just 97 yards in, executed that gap wedge really well. Talked to a few members, Julie, and they said that's what a lot of the players do.
Yeah, we saw Borja coming out of the rough earlier from the rough and just really cannot get any control even from 83 yards. Yeah. Or you can land it in the front part.
That was very well played.
5 or 6 feet.
I mean, she couldn't have landed it any better than that.
And if you were just a little bit offline, you could still, you know, use the hills, the sides to funnel it back in.
Birdie putt on the way, and a good one there by Megan Schofill at the seventh. This back and forth battle continues. It's what you want to see. Two quality shots, paid off a three.
Playing the hole differently, and they both come out with the same score.
Relative to the rest of those that move on to Saturday semis.
Third for Schofill now at the eighth.
Yeah, plenty of green to work with, right to left break. No, and that was the touch of class right there.
Before you run through that tape at the end.
This for eagle to win the hole, Anna Davis.
Yeah, not a lot of movement to it, uphill.
Great run. How about this shot, Kay, for Anna Davis? A
touchy little shot, 46 yards to the hole. Has to clip it and be aggressive with this. Oh, Julie, how about that little play? Little low spinner.
That was a beautiful.
Three hole is so important. You know this is going to be close all the way down to the end. Just this to avoid going two down. Boom, how about that up and down, Julie? That goes, you gotta give her a nod for that.
I'd give her a big nod. A chipper would be happy about that.
Let's go back to 12.
Here is that par putt to tie the hole for Megan Schofill.
Good putt. Nice putt.
That it was.
Schofill 4, Schofill remains one up.
For her draw. Really good tempoed swing there, and this starting on a great line.
Beautiful shot. That's the best we've seen all day, Kay.
Be on the speedy side, playing a good foot and a half of break.
I could have told her how speedy it was after we had it closest to the pin with Amelia, Kay, and I.
Oh, she knows that was a golden opportunity missed. And I think Megan Schofill just breathed a big sigh of relief.
Match remains Schofill one up.
This is downhill. Just a little bit of right to left. Oh, boy, a couple putts in a row that looked like they had a great chance to go. The championship till 89. Okay, this putt uphill, little bit of movement left to right. Oh boy, it kind of straightened out at the end. And that will be conceded.
Davis 5, Schofill 5. The match remains Schofill 1 up.
Nice to be able to have an 8-iron into this hole on just using again that just that stock little draw. Beautifully struck shot.
Now she went after that, Julie.
And we may see a concession now. And you know, she's still in control of this match. And yes, she lost that hole, but they're tied now.
We'll see. It'll be interesting to see with Anna getting the tee how this will affect her. You know, I think right now, you know, she's a little faster player.
Give it a good wrap. Nice effort. Right at the heart, back to one up, Megan Schofill.
Birdies, just can't have you. Megan just can't make mistakes.
That's a wedge on its way. Drawing it in a little bit. Oh, how about that tasty little shot when she needed it?
And that's why you want to do exactly what you just said, Julie.
Exactly.
For birdie and the win. Does it in style, Megan Schofill. How about that match?
You know, when you can play 18 holes and only make one mistake, that's playing a lot of great golf. She's got to be super pleased with the way she played today.